Number 10. Tyron Woodley defeated rising welterweight contender Kelvin Gastelum by a split decision at UFC 183. He was then scheduled to face Johnny Hendricks at UFC 192 in a possible number one contenders bout. But just a day before the weigh-ins, Johnny Hendricks was admitted to the hospital due to an intestine blockage and the fight was called off. Tyron Woodley decided to sit out for a year and a half to fight the champion Robbie Lawler. Both fighters met at UFC 201, where Tyron Woodley shocked the world when he knocked out Robbie Lawler in the first round, becoming the new UFC welterweight champion of the world. Number 9. Betch Koheya was granted the title shot at UFC 190 against then champion Ronda Rousey after defeating two of her teammates, Jasmine Duke and Shayna Baszler. Betch Koheya was on a 3-fight winning streak and hadn't faced anyone in the top 5 of the UFC women's bantamweight division. Ronda Rousey accepted a challenge and they faced off at UFC 190. In the fight, Ronda Rousey knocked out Betch Koheya in just 34 seconds, retaining her title. Number 8. After Michael Bisping became the UFC middleweight champion at UFC 199, the UFC decided to give the next title shot to Dan Henderson, who was coming off a victory over unranked Hector Lombard. Dan Henderson also hadn't faced anyone in the top 5 of the UFC middleweight division. The only reason that this fight was made was because Dan Henderson brutally knocked out Michael Bisping at UFC 100, and the fight would easily sell in Manchester, England. Both fighters faced off at UFC 204, where Michael Bisping defeated Dan Henderson by a close unanimous decision. Number 7. Frankie Edgar was granted the title shot at UFC 156 against then champion Jose Aldo. He was coming off of 2 title losses from Benson Henderson. The UFC president Dana White advised him to make the drop down to the featherweight division as he was too small for the 155-pound division. Frankie Edgar hadn't even stepped foot in the UFC featherweight division and was given the title shot. The super fight took place at UFC 156, where Jose Aldo defeated Frankie Edgar by a unanimous decision. Number 6. With a 6-fight winning streak, Joe Soto was set to make his UFC debut against Anthony Berchak at UFC 177. The main event of the card was Henan Barao facing off against TJ Dillashaw for the UFC bantamweight title. On the day of the weigh-ins, Henan Barao was admitted to the hospital due to collapsing whilst cutting weight. In a last-minute replacement, newcomer Joe Soto was given the main event slot against TJ Dillashaw for the UFC bantamweight title. In the fight, TJ Dillashaw knocked out Joe Soto in the 5th round to retain his belt. Number 5. John Jones was scheduled to face number 1 contender Anthony Johnson at UFC 187. Just a couple of weeks before the fight, John Jones was involved in a hit and run accident. He was stripped of the UFC light heavyweight title and was suspended. Daniel Cormier was coming off a unanimous decision loss to John Jones at UFC 182. He was given the opportunity by the UFC to step in on short notice and face Anthony Johnson for the vacant UFC light heavyweight title in the main event at UFC 187. In the fight, Daniel Cormier defeated Anthony Johnson by a rear naked choke in the 3rd round to become the new UFC light heavyweight champion of the world. Number 4. Daniel Cormier had just won the UFC light heavyweight title at UFC 187. With John Jones out of the picture due to his problems outside of the octagon, there were not many contenders left to face Daniel Cormier next. The UFC decided to give Alexander Gustafsson the chance to fight for the title. In his last fight, he had lost to Anthony Johnson by TKO at UFC on Fox 14. Both fighters faced off at UFC 192, where Daniel Cormier defeated Alexander Gustafsson by a split decision, retaining his title. Number 3. John Jones was scheduled to face Lyoto Machida again at UFC 152, but Lyoto Machida declined to fight John Jones again due to the lack of time to train for the fight. Vitor Belfort, who was a middleweight at that time, stepped up to face John Jones for the UFC light heavyweight title. In the fight, John Jones defeated Vitor Belfort by a submission via an Americana in the 4th round, retaining his title. Number 2. The UFC light heavyweight champion John Jones was set to face Dan Henderson at UFC 151. Dan Henderson suffered an injury and was forced to withdraw from the event. UFC middleweight Chael Sonnen, who was coming off a loss to then UFC middleweight champion Anderson Silva, stepped up to face John Jones on short notice. John Jones declined to fight him and the event was cancelled. With the fans wanting to see the fight, the UFC put both fighters on The Ultimate Fighter and they eventually faced off at UFC 159, where John Jones defeated Chael Sonnen by TKO in the 1st round, retaining his title. Number 1. Brock Lesnar made his UFC debut with the record of 1-0 against Frank Mir at UFC 81. He lost the fight by submission via a knee bar in the first round. His next fight was against Heath Herring at UFC 97, where he won the fight by a unanimous decision. The UFC then decided to give him a title shot against then UFC heavyweight champion Randy Couture. He defeated Randy Couture by TKO in the second round to become the new UFC heavyweight champion of the world. It is crazy to think that Brock Lesnar lost his debut fight in the UFC and then won a fight to get a title shot with a record of 2-1. With that being said, he was an incredible athlete and did go on to become one of the longer reigning heavyweight champions in UFC history.